guys, I'm Jose, and I'm an intern here at the Wetlands. Now, with me, we're going to talk about root processes, which usually take a long time, but I get to show you guys in a matter of minutes. So, to start off with, we have three processes which occur in nature. Weathering, which is you're breaking down of rocks into smaller particles, into smaller rocks, into pebbles, and eventually sand. Now, those sediments have to be moved elsewhere. So we call the movement of sediment erosion, by means of water and wind. Now lastly, they have to be dropped off somewhere. So we call that process deposition. All right, so we have a stream table model so for us to show you guys in real time these processes, which usually occur over a long time. So once I turn on the nozzle, we'll be able to see water currents happening, and with food coloring, which I'll use to show you guys the strongest current. Okay. Now, once I turn it on, we'll be able to see this happening in real time. So with me, I have a little stream going on, and with a little food coloring, it'll show us the strongest current. As you can see, we saw that our strongest current at this edge, but as it went down the wetlands, it got a lot slower. Now, something really important to see around here is the erosion happening under this house. Because of the strongest current, it's eating away the most land off that side. It's actually dropping it off from here. You're able to see all this happening all along the mount, all along the river. Now, one also important thing to talk about right here is how the river is also eroding here, and it's depositing some more land right in the middle of the river and splitting it off, which we call a delta, which is happening a little earlier than usual, but that's totally fine. Now, at the mouth of the river, we get to see a wetlands. A wetlands in nature helps prevent erosion because of the roots of the plants holding down the soil. Now, all we're dropping another drop of food coloring, we'll be able to see the weaker current by the wetlands because of how effective they are in preventing the erosion. Now, this side over here didn't have any wetlands or vegetation, so it was not protected as well. And we get to see all this happening, which would take a long time. So I want you guys to keep a really good eye out by your rivers and streams, and see erosion and weathering and deposition happening in real time. All right? Be safe.